Hello and welcome to today's Living Word. I'm Dwayne Matz. We're running a little late today, so this will be today and tomorrow's Living Word. We're in the book of Isaiah, and we're in chapter 7. I want to look at verses 18 and 19 today. And it shall come to pass in that day that the Lord will whistle for the fly that is in the farthest part of the rivers of Egypt, and for the bee that is in the land of Assyria. They will come, and all of them will rest in the desolate valleys and in the clefts of the rocks, and on all thorns and in all pastures. That's Isaiah 7, 18 and 19. I don't know, have you ever seen bees swarm? It's one of my earliest childhood memories of growing up on the farm. I remember one day the sky was just virtually black with bees. They were everywhere, clouding up the sky as they were searching for a new place to live. Their new abode could be in the clefts of rocks or any opening for that matter, or in the hollows of trees or nests built in bushes and trees. But the thing of it is, God is going to whistle for these foreign armies, and they will come and overrun Judah and then settle in every nook and cranny in the land. It's his plan. It's what he said he would do to judge the sins of Judah, and he did it. If you ever find yourself struggling with the concept of the sovereignty of God, remember this verse from Isaiah. God is able to whistle for the fly and the bee, and like a trained dog, they will come and do his bidding. The bee and fly have no choice. They must do what the Lord says. The point is that he has the same power over the nations. He is able to move them around like a giant board game of risk. Proverbs 21:1 tells us, the king's heart is in the hand of the Lord, like the rivers of water. He turns it wherever he wishes. Now, we may not like what we see going on in the nations of the world, but as bad as it may seem, God has a reason and he has a plan, and he uses these nations as pawns to carry it out. Now, whatever it may be that we don't like about the situation in the nations of the world, well, let us humbly make it a matter of prayer, petitioning the one who created the risk board, the one who really can do something about it. And maybe, just maybe, he's using these situations to stir us up as an arm of his mercy. I'm Dwayne Matz, and that's today's Living Word.